number 8 of NCERT NPO. Following is the receipts and payments of Indian Sports Club. Prepared income and expenditure account balance sheet as on 31st December 2013. Receipts and payments account is available over here. You can see there are some items like opening balances of cash balance, subscription, live membership fees, entrance fees, tournament fund, locker rent, sale of sports equipment, sale of newspaper legacy. And at the same time, you will see the payment side like electrics, some expenses randomly is given. There is tournament expenses is given, furniture purchase is given. And at the same time, sports equipment is given and closing balances are given. There is one hidden adjustment also, fixed deposit on 1/10/2006 for 10% per annum, 30,000. Switching towards the other information, what are available? Subscription outstanding on 31st December 2012, 1200 is mentioned. And 3200 December 2013, that is your opening. Closing, locker rent outstanding is given, salary outstanding is given on January 1st 2013, that is opening balance of building, furniture and sports equipments are mentioned over here, on which we are supposed to charge depreciation for the same. So very first thing, now when we are starting with the sum, the very first thing we are going to make a tick mark on the adjustments. Take a pencil in your hand and in the textbook we have to make a tick mark irrespectively. First adjustments is respect to subscription. Make a tick mark on subscription please. Then comes your locker rent. Very next to subscription you will observe receipts and payments, fourth item, locker rent is available. Then comes your next salary. On the payment side, very first item, salary is mentioned. Then comes your building. There is no adjustment respect to building in the receipts and payments account. Only depreciation is to be charged. No purchase, nothing is there. But furniture and sports equipment. Simultaneously, you will find furniture and sports equipment in the line on the payment side. And on the debit side, that is your receipt side, there is one item, sale of old sports goods. Sports goods is considered as equipment itself. So, we have to make a tick mark on that also. Now, switching towards the posting part. So first you have to draw opening balance sheet, income and expenditure account and closing balance sheet. I hope you are ready with the income and expenditure, opening balance sheet and closing balance sheet. Now we will start with the posting of that. Very first step you have to do is start posting all the items of receipts and payments in a respective manner. On the screen you will see I have ready-made answer for that, but I will make a tick mark as per the requirement. So have a look on that. So very first thing you will see receipts and payments, very first item is balance brought down 7890. So come to your opening balance sheet, transfer that cash balance 7890. Then comes your subscription. Now we had already made a tick mark on subscription. Come to your income and expenditure. And there you will find out, you will write down by subscription in a column 52,000. Keep it as it is. Leave somewhere like four lines. And then go to the next part. Then comes your life membership fees. Now life membership fees is a capital nature. So they will be added in the capital fund. Come to your closing balance sheet. Over there, very first item on the liability side, write down capital fund. Add life membership fees. 2200 over there. Very next, entrance fee. The same effect, entrance fee will be in the income and expenditure credit side, as it is an income for the business. After leaving four lines of subscription, you have to write down by entrance fee 3200. Written. Then comes your tournament fund. Now tournament fund is a liability, it is of capital income. So come to your balance sheet, closing, tournament fund in a column 26,000. Then comes your locker rent. Come to your income and expenditure again. There by locker rent in a column you make a tick mark over there. So you have to leave one line over there. Then comes your sale of old sports equipment. Now, in sale of sports equipment, you will observe that there is costing given 2200 and there is 2500 in the outer column. You have to first write down by profit on sale of sports goods rupees 300. Have you seen that? Understood? It is available in income and expenditure, income side, because it is our profit. The another effect of this 2200 will be reflecting in the closing balance sheet, that later on we will do it, because yet we don't have a sports equipment figures available. As we are moving with the sum, we will make a tick mark of that. Sale of old newspaper. Sale of old newspaper is income for us. So income and expenditure credit side by sale of newspaper 750. Then comes legacy. Now legacy is what? Legacy is an as per the will of the person, it is a particular amount which is kept for the years and years to be utilized. So it will be coming in the capital fund. But sometimes in legacy it is mentioned that it is of revenue nature, then it is to be transferred to income and expenditure. Then comes your, then ends your receipt side posting, come to your payment side. Very first is to salary. Come to your debit side of income and expenditure and write down to salary 11,000 in a column. Why in a column? Because it is tick mark. Then simultaneously come to next part, to electric charges. Electric charges is debit, so transfer it to the income and expenditure debit side. Billiard table. Now billiard table itself is an asset, so it's a new purchase of billiard table. Come to your balance sheet closing, there you write down billiard table as an asset. Then comes your printing and stationery. Again it's an income and expenditure debit, so come to your income and expenditure debit side to printing and stationery 2300. Then comes your tournament expenses. Now stop over here. Tournament expenses. Now we already are standing with tournament fund. So tournament expenses are to be deducted from tournament expenses. So here come to your tournament fund, which is already transferred to the balance sheet liability side. There you write down less expenses 18,500. So outer figures gives you 7,500. That is 26,000 minus 18,500. I hope you understood up to this. Then comes your repair of ground. Income and expenditure debit side, repair of ground. Debit side, income and expenditure, repair of ground. You people write down to repair of ground. I guess I missed out. It is repair of grant. By mistake, instead of ground, I have written grant, but it's okay. I guess you understood. 2000 rupees. Then comes your furniture purchase. Come to your closing balance sheet. There write down buy furniture. Sorry, don't write buy. Write down only furniture. Closing balance sheet, furniture. Leave the space. Leave the space. You don't write down amount you don't have. There you write down plus purchase, 7700. Then, if you remember, I have skipped sale of old. 7700, that's it. Then comes your furniture purchase. Again write down furniture on the asset side only. Leave the space, then write down plus purchase 7700. Now you had already, you know, I have skipped 2200 effects, sale of old sports equipment or goods, which is mentioned in the textbook as goods, 2200. Deduct that. So ultimately 2200 is also transferred. Then comes your cash in hand and cash at bank. Again in the closing balance sheet, cash in hand and cash at bank is to be transferred in the normal form. Cash in hand, cash at bank. Okay. Then comes your fixed deposit, purchase on 1/10/2006. So write down fixed deposit in a column 30,000. Here the hidden adjustment is there, which I am going to complete over here only. Fixed deposit is 30,000. So, interest will be received for 10% for how many months? Count with your fingers. 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 10, 11, 12, 3 months. Because your ending is December. So ultimately 30,000 at rate 10% for 3 months gives you 3,600. $750. So outer column gives you 30750. Sorry, again I am explaining fixed deposit. Fixed deposit is standing with 30,000 at rate 10% per annum, and from 1/10/2006 up to 31st December we have to count. So 30,000 multiplied by 10 upon 100 multiplied by 3 upon 12, that gives you 750 rupees that is to be added. So 30,750 is outer figure what you got for the income, for the 30750 you got. Come to your income and expenditure and transfer that by income from fixed deposit, 750. That's it. Now we will fully focus on other information what is available. So very first is subscription outstanding is on 31st March 2012. This is subscription of previous year, rupees 1200. So previous year subscription we are going to minus, and 3200 subscription of December 31st 2013 we are going to add. So this both effects in the final subscription, that is income and expenditure, income side by subscription is already mentioned by you people, that is 52,000 plus 3200 of the outstanding current year and minus outstanding previous year 1200. So these are the final effects, and the final answer you will get is 54,000. But at the same time we have to transfer this both to the opening and the closing balance sheet. So in the opening balance sheet we will be transferring outstanding subscription 1200, and at the same time in the closing balance sheet we will be transferring outstanding subscription 3200. Clear? Then comes your locker rent. It will be treated in the same way of outstanding current year, rupees 250. So by locker rent you had already mentioned, locker rent is standing with 1250 plus outstanding 250, so outer gives you 1500. So simultaneous effect in the closing balance sheet. So switching towards that, come to your balance sheet, asset side, locker rent outstanding 250. Then comes your salary outstanding, rupees 1000. Switching towards two salary debit side, you had already mentioned. There you write down plus outstanding CY, 1000 rupees, outer column gives you 12,000. And come to your closing balance sheet. In the closing balance sheet, you are supposed to write down liability side, outstanding salary, rupees 1000. Now come to your transferring of the balances which are available. That is building first 36,000. Come to your opening balance sheet. Write down 36,000 over there. Then furniture 12,000 over there. And at the same time, sports equipment 17,500 over there. So all the items are to be transferred. Now these are all opening balance for the next coming year, because this is a closing for 1st January 2013. So it will be closing for the this is opening for the next closing balance sheet. Come to your closing balance sheet. There you write down first building 36,000. See on the screen, 36,000 is mentioned, underlined. Furniture 12,000 and sports equipment 17,500. The space already is left by us when we were doing the purchase and the sales items of this all respective assets. Now I will be focusing individually on all these items for charging the depreciation. So please come to your building part. So building, you had mentioned 36,000. Right? Less depreciation 10%. So that gives you 30 to 400 outside. Come to your next part, that is your furniture. Furniture is standing with as we have left the space, 12,000 will be there, plus purchase, already we have mentioned 7,200, both will give you 19,700, less depreciation, 1,970. So outer will be there as 17,730. And at the same time, come to your sports equipment is standing with rupees 17,500, plus we have made a purchase of 12,000, that gives you total of 29,500, less we had already made a sale of 2,200. So I had explained you that we will make a effect of that. So now I guess now it's all compiled, and now you had understood 2,200 is your sale of costing, so we had to minus from that. So ultimately sports equipment standing within our books of accounts is 27,300, less depreciation 10%, 2,730. So outer columns gives you 24,570. All the three depreciation items are now to be transferred to the income and expenditure debit side. Come to your income and expenditure debit side. You will observe here, I have already mentioned two depreciation, sports equipment 2,730, furniture 1,970, building 3,600, outer columns gives you 8,300. You can directly put down this all depreciation item outside also, but I have written in the compiled form. That answers some now. So very first thing we have to do is opening balance sheet. Come to your opening balance sheet, close your opening balance sheet, you will observe capital fund over there. So taking a total of both the sides, you will find 74,590 and 74,590. So ultimately difference is capital fund 74,590. Transfer this 74,590 into the closing balance sheet, very closing debit liability side. Capital fund inner column 74,590. Over there, membership and legacy, all we had already mentioned over there. Now come to your income and expenditure. On the income and expenditure, what we have to do is make a total in your rough of both the sides. First, I will make a credit side total, that is income side total, and then I will make a debit side total. I will see which side is more. The side which is more is to be deducted with the less amount. That is, if your income is coming with 60,500, or obviously expenses side will be less, so you have to minus that, and the difference you will get is 26,300. So that is termed as surplus, or you can say excess of income over expenditure. Yani iska matlab kya hua, hamare paas income jyada hai expenses ke saath mein samne. Now this surplus is to be added in our capital fund as per the profit, or you can say, you cannot say profit because it is NPO, but you can say surplus amount we have received for the same. So by adding this, so ultimately our full structure of the balance sheet, I will say once, have a look on that please. 74,590 we have transferred from opening balance sheet of the capital fund. Life membership fees added, legacy we had added, surplus is added. So ultimately 140,590 is our outer column figure. Tournament fund we have taken out, and salary outstanding 1,000. So, and at the same time on the asset side, we had few items which we already transfer, and I guess you had understood that in a very perfect form. And now make a grand total of that, and the final grand total will be 149,090. That is 149,090. So they both tally, and that ends the sum. Thank you.